heard from the two camps. I'm going to introduce both fighters now. The fight itself really is compelling. I speak to so many guys in this boxing industry, and they say, this is a fight. It's a fight people are interested in, people want to see. And I'm pleased we've been able to put this together. Looking forward to seeing it on June 7th at Turning Stone Casino. So at this point in time, I'm going to introduce a man from, originally born in Brooklyn, lives out in Long Island now, has really been something special from the Paramount series that we've had. You know, Chris Algieri is fighting tonight. He was developed with Paramount. Joe Smith, you saw, when he knocked out Bernard Hopkins, Fonfera, and the like. He was that developed through the Paramount. Well, so was Cletus Selden. And Cletus, if you ever been to the Paramount shows, you know. I mean, he's got the fans yelling, Hebrew Hammer. They love the knockout power, and he's a real banger, an exciting fighter, right? A throwback, again a testament to Pete's style of having a guy crowd and crouch like the old 1950s. But he's something special, and he's really established a name for himself in New York. And I'm pleased to introduce to you, he's got a record of 23-1 with 19 knockouts. This is the only man he shares with Roy Jones and Mike Tyson as one of only three men to be back-to-back co-featured fights on featured fights on HBO. That's a good company to be in. And in that fight, which the second fight on HBO, which is the one fight that he lost, he had an injury. He hasn't spoken about it, but frankly, he had Tommy John surgery, had to be conducted right after that fight. So it's a real testament to him as well, because he wanted to go into that fight anyway, to join the ranks of Roy Jones and Mike Tyson. But really, he's got a real tremendous background, tremendous knockout power, and an exciting fighter, Cletus, the Hebrew Hammer Selden. Cletus?
Joe was interested. He invited me to a kosher deli, knowing I'm a Jewish boy. I want to eat bagels and lox and all this stuff. That's crazy. That's his style, and that's why he picked this fight together. He knows that I can bring the most exciting fight for him in his stable. I know that. But reality is, I got respect for Zeb Judah, six-time world champion, a legend in the sport. I respect everything he's done. I respect that he even went out, had to get a job to support his family, had to do that. I respect that we're fighting on Hall of Fame weekend in front of legends. Any athlete in any sport would love to do that in front of people. But when we get in the ring, and that bell rings until the last bell rings, I have no respect, I have no care, I just have determination and one job in mind, and that's hurting the other individual in front of me, and that's it. That's all I got to say.
Thank you, Prince. So, Cletus will be fighting six-time world champion, a man who's got tremendous experience in that ring. You know, when you think about, Zab Judah came out of the amateurs at 139 pounds, 139-pound champion. He's fighting now, how many years later is this? Right? Fighting decades later. And what's his weight? The same exact, okay? By 1 pound, because in the pros it's 140, not 139.
And that ain't discipline, I don't know what it is.
Absolutely, that's discipline. And, you know, it's one of the reasons why he's been able to be six-time world champion. One of the reasons why right now he'll be able to fight on Friday night at Turning Stone Casino for the NABA 140-pound championship. 1 pound over his amateur days. And that's something special. Zab has really been a special fighter. He's Brooklyn through and through. He's actually been wearing it today. And it's a fantastic record, as you know. 44 wins, 9 losses, and we talk about Cletus' knockout power. Zab has got 30 knockouts, all right? This is a fight, an interesting fight, and I'm pleased to introduce six-time world champion, Zab Judah.
Good afternoon, everybody. I just want to
say thanks. I want to thank the media for coming out today. I want to thank Joe DeGuardia and Star Boxing for putting on this tremendous, great situation. Me and Joe striking the deal and working together. It's going to be a great deal. To my opponent, Elie Seckbach, Team Seckbach, you know, respect you guys, but welcome to the Terror Dome. You know what I mean? When they say about knockouts, I mean, I don't even got to talk about it. I mean, I got more knockouts than he got fights. You know what I mean? So, you know what I mean? I mean, it's, you know, it's self-explanatory what's going to happen here Saturday night. You know, I want to thank Team Judah, my father, Bill, Drago, the rest of my team that helped in preparation, putting this fight together. Yo, you guys know how serious I am, how focused and dedicated I am for this fight coming up Friday night. Like I said, Friday night, the show of Super Judah and Team Judah, the train shall continue. Start with Elie Seckbach.
Thank you, Zab. So remember, it'll be June 7th, Turning Stone Casino. All of the activity will start live at 6:45 p.m. at Turning Stone. And the actual feed will start then as well on Fight.tv. The main event, co-main event will go on around sometime around 9:15 p.m. Okay? Tickets are still available up there. I know we're sold out at ringside. The floor is sold out, but there's still other tickets available in the upper sections. And get your tickets, come out there. If you can't get them, watch it on Fight.tv. Great night of boxing, great main event. Thank you all, I appreciate you coming. If there's any questions now, we will drop to a couple of questions only, and then we'll take some photos from Krause.
Any questions?
Yes.
Zeb, Jimmy from Boxing Action Magazine. I saw you come in very serious, very determined. I haven't seen that look in your face for a long time. Your father mentioned how hard you worked for this industry. 23 years as a professional. Your ledger is stuff of legend. What keeps you motivated to train and to stay focused for a fight like this?
I love what I do. I love what I do. Opportunities. You know, this is an opportunity of performing in a place where I will go down at as one of the Hall of Fame fighters. So to be able to perform the same weekend in dominant fashion, I mean, that's what pushes me to go in and do it. And to do it with a fighter such as a Elie Seckbach, you know, such as a known knockout artist and guy like that, you know, everybody that's been put in front of him, you know, he's done a farewell with. And you know what I'm saying, to go in there and dismantle a guy like that, it's gonna be great.
Any other questions?
For the hammer, how does it feel? You're fighting a legend. You're fighting a guy, a lot of experience. Is there a certain extra motivation for you in this fight? I mean, you can hit. You're fighting one of the great fighters every year. Any thoughts on fighting this afternoon?
Yeah, someone mentioned to me, you know, you think this would be the biggest name in boxing you ever fight? I actually said, yeah, it is. There's never going to be, for another 10 years, a legend that's going to come around. So every day I woke up, every day I trained, every day I thought of anything, every single day, I said, wow, I'm fighting Zab, motherflocking Judah. This is awesome.
Motherflocking
okay, Judah. Okay. So I'm getting trouble. Like, I do that. How awesome is that? I get to fight on Star Boxing card in front of all those legends that are going to be in attendance for a title that they got. Because when they asked us, you know, this was originally a 10-round, 144-pound title fight. Then it went down to 140, and then when they asked if you wanted to be a 10-round or a 12-round, I said I want 12 rounds. Because that's the road that I have always taken, the hardest road possible. I want the hardest road, just like in life. That's what we choose, and every boxer knows that that road is rough. We never go down that straight path ever. And I'm excited at all times for us.
Joe, you got Buddy McGirt Jr. in this car. A little showman in you there. His dad's inducted that weekend. He was talking to him on Russia. Talk about having him in there, him on the car. He's not because he's Buddy's son, but he's a good fighter.
He's a good fighter, and he's been training down in Florida. He looks spectacular in the gym. And we expect some big things. The winner of that fight will be in line for a major fight. This is a major fight. He's fighting David Poe, an undefeated fighter from France, rated number 5 in the world. This will be a title fight. And, you know, Bobby Jr.'s got a good opportunity in front of him. He's looking forward to it. I spoke with his dad. His dad thinks it's a tough fight.
he knows it's a tough fight.
But this is what it's about. It's about opportunity.